In this video, I will show you why you need to get IT certification and which one you should choose. This is for anyone interested in this topic without any prior experience or has 20 years of experience. So let's start right now. We'll be talking about what is IT certification, why you should go for it, and which IT certification you should choose. IT certification is a proof of certain level of professional competency in a specific technology domain. So you can think of it as a proof for your current or next employer that you have the required skills to do a certain job. I would like to be very clear that IT certification does not replace working experience that is required in most jobs, but provides a good start for any job seeker. I know most of you know why IT certification is important, but let me try to emphasize more on this topic as it will help us in planning later. And I want to be very clear and convincing to you as much as possible. I will start with the first reason that it will enhance your chance in winning your next job interview. IT certification helps you to stand out from the crowd. Imagine all computer science fresh graduates and others apply for a job, so nearly most of them have no previous experience. The main focus for the interviewer will be on the graduation project and any other advantage. Here the certification will put you in better position in such competition. IT certification shows credibility and commitment to self-improvement, which are both considered behavioral competencies that all recruiters seek. Your CV or LinkedIn will look more attractive to potential employers where you are having a certification section showing multiple certifications. Most recruiters use recruitment automated software. This software uses several techniques like keywords or artificial intelligence to identify qualified applicant pool for a job opening and rank the CV by relevancy. Most job descriptions will contain the required certification and the qualification for the job, so you will always rank high if your CV contains the required certification. Imagine yourself as an interviewer with a limited time. Having certification in the CV will eliminate lots of questions regarding a specific technology domain, as it is already covered by the certification exam. You will focus your questions on the working experience in that domain. No doubts that the certification and the experience in a domain is the killer winning combination in most job interviews. Certification professional compensation usually is greater than the non-certified. Some have doubts regarding this point. I appreciate you can search the internet by the certification name and average salary and you will get your answer. Also, we will show and will include a lot of links in this video that will show this point of view. During salary negotiations, recruiters will review your CV maybe several times. If you are requesting higher than the average salary for the job, they are looking for a reason why they need to pay you that much. Here comes your certification as a definite help. IT certification adds to your professional development by keeping you up to date with all IT trends in the market. You will speak the global IT language for a specific domain as most certifications have lots of definitions and clarification for a certain area. You will become a faster troubleshooter in this technology domain. It will increase your productivity as well. It will help in career shifting or applying for higher positions like shifting from system administrator to infrastructure architect or from developer to architect. You will need a proof of your competency. IT certification can be important for serious managers as well. It will keep their technical knowledge up to date. It can be considered a minimal level of information about a technology topic. Let's say that you are ahead for IT operation and you are making the move from virtualization to containerization. You can get this knowledge by reading lots of articles and best practices by well-known consultation firms like Gartner or Forrester. Other managers think I need to be with my team during this, and this is considered major transformation to my company. So I will select relevant certification to go for it, to either gain better understanding or have real hands-on. You can start with yourself in achieving certain certification. Just pass it and start encouraging your team members to go for it by listing the benefit of the certification and your experience in passing it. You will find lots of your team members will follow. For companies, IT certifications are very important as well. It enhances professional services portfolio for your company. Let's assume that you are a company providing consultation or implementation services for the cloud. Having a list of certified professionals is very important in winning any bid. Even big companies that are evaluated by Gartner or Forrester are checked by the percentage of certified engineers in this company. It will help you in the company transformation. Let's assume that you are a company and you want to adapt to DevOps or Agile. You can do it by engaging a consultation firm that will work with your team, and your major obstacle will be the resistance of a change mindset by your team, unfortunately. Or you can sponsor the relevant certification and encourage your employees to achieve it. This certification will do the big part of changing their mindset, and they will love applying what they have studied in that company during the transformation. Also, they will feel that the company is caring to their professional development. Some companies use it as an employee key performance indicator and use it in assessing yearly promotions and career development as well. As a certification requires time and money investment, deciding which certification as early as possible will save you both. I believe your decision should be based on four main sources. You need to decide what is your IT career plan. I'm not asking you to plan for a long time, but for the next 5 years it will be more than enough, as IT changes very frequently. Well-known companies provide a clear certification path for every career. Every icon you can see provides a link to a certification path, and for sure more companies are providing the same. This video is not sponsored and the companies are sorted alphabetically. Please have a look at such career paths in line with your target IT career path. I just want to share the sample of what we are having here in the links. First one, I will go for AWS. As you can see, it is showing all the certification by the roles. So let's assume that I will go for the data scientist. Here it is providing all the paths for the data scientist. Certification from Cisco. Certification of Cisco, it is, you can see here, it is showing the levels from entry associate to an architect level, and then making it in a matrix with available certification, every link for a certification on this level. Google, they are providing a small level, a small part of certification. Microsoft itself, it is having, of course, a comprehensive. Let's say that I will select a solution architect here. It will go, all the related certification are already shown. Oracle as well, but it is doing it by product. So let's say that I want to be a SaaS or SaaS EPM, or let's say I will go for Java certification. I will click on the Java. It will show you Java Standard Edition, Java Enterprise Edition. I will go for it. It will list me the certification path for something like this. Red Hat, of course, provides all the certifications from the very starting level RHCSA to the highest level and automation and the architecture level as well from here. Your expected salary plays a big role in your certification selection. When searching the internet, you will find articles, blogs, surveys, and research studies having lots of information. Mainly companies in recruitment, certification, and training make such researches on a yearly basis. Companies like Glassdoor and Robert Half do such surveys. Also, Global Knowledge makes yearly research. If you search the internet, you will find for the years 2018, 2019, and 2020. That will give you a lot of insights and what have changed across the years. iCert Global and PrepAway provide also a very good articles. I found a separate articles from Business News Daily. It was providing the best certification by career path. Big data, cloud, network. PayScale, which is a compensation platform, provides lots of reports by different dimensions. you will find reports by industry, city, job category. I found them very comprehensive. Please click on the above links and read the research. Knowing the average salary when you are just reading is not enough. Please spend your time in reading the whole articles. It will give you a lot of insights and understanding how the IT market is going and moving forward. If you checked all previous links for top paying certification, you will not find much about artificial intelligence and big data, which is considered really very strange case. I believe these two domains are the current and the future of the IT. And if you believe the same, you need to ask yourself a question. Why is the previous surveys wrong? It is not the case, but usually surveys are restricted by timing and conditions for applying, and the availability of the information, and a lot of other conditions. So, in such case, you need to research the internet for studies that assist your vision before proceeding further. Here I provide two links to such articles for the case of artificial intelligence if you are interested. Just let me browse with you some of the links I have already provided. First one here, you see the 29 most valuable IT certification, and you will find a listing of all of them, so you can assess your decision for going in this field by making sure it is being listed in this value. Here is the latest from Global Knowledge for the year 2020, and here is the top paying certification. I really appreciate if you read this article. I know it is maybe it's quite long, but it is having a lot of insights. And here is some reasons. You see, something like just missed the cut. Something like the Scrum Master, you will find it in 2019 and it is not there in 2018. They will give us some insights why it has not been missed or it is not included. Here is, this is a good article I mentioned about best IT certification for 2019 from Business News Daily. Okay, and it is the certification, best big data certification for business continuity, for cloud, a lot of certification. You will just click the link and it will show you the best in this field. Here is a pay scale, which is the compensation platform. You don't imagine, here is a certification. Whenever you are clicking any one of them or going for the researches here, you will find a lot of insights about a specific job. Here, this is the case for the artificial intelligence. It is a report. I searched for the artificial intelligence and I found a report from Indeed, and Indeed it is a very good recruitment company. Okay, you will find that it is a top 10 jobs involving AI levels, and here is the average salary for these jobs. The same one, how to become a machine learning, but it will also mention this is here the average salary. All previous dimensions should be taken into consideration while choosing an IT certification. It should be based on researches. The selection should be also matching your career path, so you enjoy the journey. It will be helping also during your study for the next certification. I hope that you have a look to the previously mentioned articles to be well prepared for the next video. It will be all about how to efficiently study for your next certification. If you are interested, appreciate subscribing to the channel to receive a notification when the next video is uploaded. All the contents you have seen, including PowerPoint and more, are available in my blog post, and you will find a link below in the video description. If you are having any more inquiries, I will be more than happy to answer your questions in the comments below. And please remember, sharing is caring. So if you know someone who will be interested in this topic, just hit the share button. Thanks for your time watching the video. I hope you liked it. If so, please hit the like button to encourage me to make more videos. And really, thanks for watching.